What's the matter, sweetheart? Oh.
No, it's horrible.
Oh. It was just a bad dream. You don't ever have to be afraid of anything. I'll always be here to protect you.
Good morning, honey.
Good morning, sweetheart.
How about some coffee?
Yeah, big one. Somebody kept me up last night.
Well, I'm sorry. I had a nightmare. You didn't seem to mind so much last night.
Oh, no. It was probably just spending the night in a new house is all.
Yeah, I know. I have to admit, this place is kind of strange.
Yeah, it's different. You know, I bet the guy that built this place must have been really bizarre.
Well, hi, Spaz.
How you doing, huh? Hey.
What are you gonna do today, sweetheart?
Well, I don't know. I'm almost finished unpacking. Thought maybe I'd do a little exploring.
Yeah.
How about you?
Do you see that bathroom yet on the second floor?
Yeah.
I like that. I think I'm gonna turn it into a photo lab for myself. Keep me busy for a week or so.
That's a good idea.
What's in that box?
Well, I don't know. I haven't gone through it yet.
Let's see.
Oh, it's Christmas ornaments. Oh, look at this.
What?
Just a sec. You remember this?
Yeah. Yeah, I gave you this for Halloween.
You rat! You know it was Christmas Eve. It was the night you proposed to me.
Are you sure I proposed to you?
Yes.
Of course I remember. Of course I do.
You're forgiven.
I better get to work. I got a lot to do. I'm gonna keep this little fella with me, though, so I'll always remember that fateful night.
Well, don't work too hard. See you later. Damn it, it's locked.
Well, hello there, little lady. What can I do you for?
Yeah, are you Bob Tompkins?
When's the last time I took a look?
My husband bought a house from you.
Too bad you got a husband, honey. Now, have a seat. Love to do that. What's his name?
Asshole.
What was that?
Gordon. Donald Gordon.
Gordon. Gibson, Gleason, Gordon. Yeah. Donald Gordon. Here we go. Oh. Who's them people what took over the old Caravash estate?
It's Carnavash.
I remember now. Your husband was that photographer. What takes the pictures for those magazines?
Yeah. Huh. Well, my husband works for several magazines. Hmm. He's doing a project for Newsday magazine right now.
Hmm. And you, little lady, you're a writer, huh?
I'm a novelist.
Oh, a novelist. So what have you noveled?
Have you heard of a book called Blue Moon Rising?
No, can't say I have.
I'm not surprised.
Well, young lady, unless there's something else, I think we'll cut this chit-chat for today. I got a lot of work to do. I got another client I'm going to meet.
I bet you do. Well, thanks. There is something.
Yes?
Keys. Are you sure you gave my husband all the keys to the Carnavash estate? There seem to be some locked doors.
Well, I gave him all I had. But if you don't believe me, why don't you just check for yourself?
Well, I think I will. Aha. Carnavash Estate. All the keys, huh? What's this?
It's a very large key. So sue me.
the hell was that? All right. A token. I'll try it out. Evil will walk once more.
Honey, you okay?
Oh, God. The bed.
What?
The bed grabbed me.
The bed grabbed you?
Yes.
Oh, here, calm down. Calm down. Wait here. Wait here, all right? Just wait here. I'll show
you. No, don't.
Just calm down. See? It's okay, Hila. See? Nothing wrong. Goodness. This old drafty house has your imagination going, doesn't it? Oh, sweetheart. I've got to get back to work. Are you going to be okay?
Yes.
You sure?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Just calm down.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah, that screwdriver slipped. It's a damn drain.
Let me see.
Oh, I'm okay. Really, I'm... You know what I could use? Some drain cleaner. Do you have any?
I don't think so. Is there anything I can do?
Yeah, hand me that wrench. Thanks, honey.
What the hell?
Thank you.
This reporter attended Carnot's Phantasmagoria show in London's Egyptian Theater last night and found it horrific, spine-tingling, and incredible. Women were swooning in the aisles at the gory realism of his spectacles. For the uninitiated, Carnot's shows are not for the faint of heart, as they feature occult images, the black arts, torture devices, bodily amputations. Of course, all are accompanied by a generous dose of screams, shrieks, howls, and frightening organ music. Those of you up to thrills and chills won't want to miss this. Dear Jeremiah, it has come to my attention that you have recently acquired a unique book while traveling through Egypt this most recent winter.
It is my understanding that this tome contains powerful information regarding ancient rituals of sorcery and magic. I relish the thought of reading it. As you know, I am sometimes frustrated by the fact that I cannot really control the world around me. That my so-called magic is merely nothing more than illusions. Next month, I will be giving a show in Paris. Will you be in town then? If so, I would like to set up a meeting during which I could examine your fascinating acquisition. If the book is really authentic, I would be more than willing to pay a hefty sum for its purchase. I look forward to hearing from you. Best regards, Zoltan.
Prognostications of evil? The devil made me do it? This guy had some strange taste. Worship of animals? Secrets of the dead?
Oh, it's a letter opener. This must be Carno's family tree. Wrestling with that lamp?
Hey, oh, it's very funny. I don't know what happened. Suddenly the damn lamp crashed down on top of my head. I just finished tightening the screws. Oh. I'm fine, Adrian. Oh. I'm gonna go upstairs, get cleaned up, put on some new clothes. I'm done for the day.
about some dinner? What would you like?
I'm not really very hungry. Maybe some tuna or salad or something. Then let's call it a night.
That sounds good. I'm kind of tired. See you downstairs about 10 minutes?
Yeah, 10 minutes.
I'm starting my new book.
So what?
Did you go buy the drain cleaner like I asked you to?
What? Drain cleaner?
Don't be coy with me. I asked you several times to go buy me drain cleaner. Now, did you do it?
Well, I know you said the sink was clogged in your darkroom, but you never asked me to go get you any drain cleaner. I would have remembered something like that.
You know, this is just like you. I bust my ass for you all the time. You don't do anything but sit on your butt like you're doing right now.
What? What is wrong with you? I don't understand.
Fine. Fine. The next time you want something, don't come crawling to me.
Fine. I'll go to the store and get your goddamn drain cleaner.
What's that music? Where's it coming from? Thank you.
you.
Good morning.
Good morning. Sir, do you have anything that would clear a badly clogged drain? You know, a drain cleaner?
A drain cleaner, huh? Well, let's see, let me think. Here we are. This will do the job.
Great.
You gotta be careful with that, though. That's sulfuric acid. I mean, it'll burn through practically anything.
I know, don't worry.
All right, then that'll be $4.75, please.
Here's five.
All right, out of five. And 25 cents of change.
Thank you.
You know, this is a small town. We don't get many visitors. Are you new here?
Yeah, my husband and I just bought the old Carnavash estate. We're doing a little renovating.
The Carnavash estate? So you're the ones who moved there.
Now wait, why does everybody look so shocked when I tell them I bought that place? What's wrong with it?
Don't you know?
Know what?
That place is haunted.
Haunted?
Shh, not so loud. They say it's haunted by the ghost of that magician. What's his name?
Carno?
Yeah, that's it. They say he died a violent death there one night, along with his wife. That was almost 100 years ago. A strange thing still happened there.
Like what?
I'm not exactly sure, but I don't keep up with those things, but if you're curious to know a little more, why, there's this old geezer. His name is Malcolm. He lives out of town a ways. He actually used to live with Carno as a boy.
As a boy? How old is this guy?
I haven't seen him for quite a while, but I'll tell you, he is old. He's gonna be over 100.
And you say he used to live with Carno?
That's what they say.
That's interesting. Well, thanks,
Harv.
Well, thanks, Harv. You've been very informative. I'll look into this Malcolm guy.
Well, good luck.
Hello? Somebody in here? Hello? John, don't scare me like that.
Scare you? I'm just trying to keep you on your toes, Adrian. You never know who will be sneaking around this place.
Sneaking around like you?
Not me, Adrian. Can't you see? We're not alone on this island.
Probably just some vagrants. I doubt they're even here anymore.
They better not be. Because if I catch their asses around here...
Don, don't. Come on, honey. They're probably gone. You know, we always have our trusty watch cat, Spaz.
Yeah, right. I don't want you hanging around out here. I want you to stay up at the house.
Why, there's a key stuck in the keyhole. What is this thing?
days, dapples and grays, all the pretty toys. Damn it, it's locked.
What do you want? I'm busy.
Come on, Don. Here's the drain cleaner you requested. Jeez.
Yeah. Thanks.
Honey, are you feeling all right? Does your head still hurt?
Adrian, leave me alone. I'm fine.
Well, how about a little dinner? You could come downstairs and help me. We can make a little pasta, maybe some salad, a little vino.
Yeah, sounds great. Call me when it's ready.
For a picnic, don't you think, honey?
Yeah, I guess so.
So good to get you out of that dark room. Yes, Beth.
Well, I've got work to do, Adrian. We're not finished yet.
Don, it can wait. You need to take some time out to relax. You're so stressed out.
I've got publishing deadlines. Can you understand that? You see, I don't get the same ass-kissing royal treatment your publisher gives you.
Don? Can you say that? I certainly do understand deadline. Honey, what's wrong?
Nothing. It's a headache, that's all.
But...
I'm gonna go lie down. Maybe you were right. Maybe I need some rest.
Please don't run. I won't hurt you.
Who are you?
I'm Cyrus. Me and Ma are living here. In the barn.
In the barn?
The barn! Ma's in trouble. You gotta come.
What?
Come on! Oh, come on. You gotta help Ma.
Help! Help me!
Oh, God.
Ma, I went and got that lady.
Well, get her up here then. I'm stuck. Help! Somebody help me! Help! This hurts!
Hurry!
Help me! Help! This hurts!
Hockaday. Blows my son Cyrus. I swear that boy can't do anything right. He'd lose his head if it wasn't screwed on tight. Cyrus, you just wait till I get my hands on you. Lady, me and Cyrus want to apologize. That is, for being a problem. Wouldn't we, Cyrus? Wouldn't we, Cyrus?
Huh? Oh, yeah.
You don't have to apologize, Harriet. Accidents happen. But even so, you and your son are going to have to leave. This is private property.
I've been thinking about that, about your property and all. And there's just no way around it. You need us.
Need you?
Yeah. How are you and your husband gonna take care of this whole place by your lonesomes, huh?
Well, I hate to admit it, you have a point there.
Now, take a look at my son here. He's as strong as an ox, can do any kind of outside work. Me, I can help around the house. I'm a great housekeeper.
Yeah, I can see that.
Well, what do you say, huh?
Yeah.
We'll work for nothing. Just room and board. Come on. Don't pitch us out in the cold. We got no place else to go.
Oh, okay. You win. You can start tomorrow. Why don't you meet me up at the house in the morning?
Yippee! We got us a job, Cyrus. You hear? What's your name, lady?
Adrian.
Adrian Delaney. My husband is Don Gordon.
Pleased to meet you, Adrian.
What are you doing?
I'm a clairvoyant. I read palms. Can I?
No, I don't think so.
Aw, come on. Let me see. So you are lifeline?
Yeah.
Well, it's real long. That's good.
But,
there's this strange other line crossing it in the middle there. Wonder what that means. Forget it. Don't mean nothing. Come on, boy, let's go fix supper.
I can't see a thing down there.
Oh, it's dusty.
It's empty. There we go. Yay, it worked. Yes. The Vampire by John Polidori. To Malcolm from Zoltan. Oh, that's the old guy from town.
That'll be $2 even. And I thank you. Come back to see us. Can I help you?
Oh, don't mind me. I'm just looking.
Okay.
Dog. Nice doggy.
Yes? What do you want?
I was wondering.
Yes?
I think I'm lost. Which way is the town?
That-a-way. You again? I already told you no.
Wait!
Well?
I found this book in the tower room. See?
Just a minute. All right, you can come in now.
Thank you.
Malcolm, she's here. Malcolm, she is here.
Come. Come here. Living in Connell's house.
Yes, sir.
You found my book.
Yes, I did, sir.
Don't call me sir. I don't like it. It makes me feel old.
Well, what should I call you?
My name is Malcolm. Call me that.
Malcolm, is it true you lived with Carno as a boy? Did you sleep in the tower room?
Yeah. Yes, I did. That was my room.
What was Carno like?
Enough. I have one question for you, and then after that You have to leave.
What is it?
Tell me, how is the house? Everything okay?
I guess. What do you mean?
Good. That's what I wanted to hear. I'm tired. You have to go now.
But...
No.
Well, thank you. Me.
And where have you been all day?
I don't know. Around? In town.
I thought I told you to stay away from all of those people.
People?
What people?
Those stupid townspeople.
Oh, this is silly.
I'm not finished with you yet.
You're telling me what to do? Well, where were you all day?
None of your business, honey.
Well, I'll tell you what. You take care of your business, and I'll take care of mine.
Well, we're gonna see about that.
Alone.
Hey, I've been waiting for you.
I'm sorry, Harriet. I forgot all about it. You ready to work?
Yeah, ma'am. Tell me what to do.
Well, let's see. Kitchen dishes need washing. Our bed needs to be made. Bathroom needs cleaning. Furniture needs polishing. And this floor needs sweeping.
I'll get right on it. Anything else?
I have a question, Harriet. When I was in the tower room, I saw a little building in the woods on the eastern side of the island. Do you know anything about it?
I've never been in those woods. The trail's washed out. Cyrus has, though. Go ask him.
Okay, I will. Thanks.
Anything else? Oh, by the way, I see you carrying around that newspaper. You want me to throw it away for you?
Please, would you?
Hey, you stupid cat. Just want to play with you is all. You stupid kitty cat. Try to run away and all I want to do is play.
Gotcha.
Cyrus? Cyrus, what are you doing?
Nothing. Ow.
What were you doing with my cat?
I was just playing with it, is all.
Cyrus, don't play with him, okay?
Okay.
Cyrus?
Huh?
When I was in the tower room, I could see a little building in the woods. I was wondering, have you seen it?
Yeah. It's over there.
Well, can you show me the way?
Well, the trail's all washed out. Usually what I do, I just jump over it.
But where is it, Cyrus?
It's over there. Okay, I'll show you. Come on, follow me. There you are. I've been waiting for you.
I'm sorry, Cyrus. I tried to hurry.
Oh, that's okay. See? There it is. Just like I told you. Come on.
Oh, I don't know, Cyrus. Looks kind of dangerous. Isn't there another way?
No. Oh! Look out! Fix it.
God, Cyrus.
There you go.
You're amazing, Cyrus. I can't believe you did that.
Of course I did. I'm strong. See?
Wow. Boy, you are strong.
Yeah, I know. Ma always tells me that I have more muscles than brains.
Yeah, well, your mother was right, Cyrus.
Heck. It ain't nothing.
Cyrus!
Oh, I gotta go.
I can't see anything. Oh, it's missing a lens piece. That other window there by the tower room. I wonder who that could be.
Hello?
that's been stalling the phone.
Hi. Yeah, I'm Mike. Your caretakers let me in.
Oh, great. I'm going nuts without a phone.
Yeah, I can understand that. This is quite a place you got here, ma'am.
Adrian. Yeah, it is quite a place, isn't it?
I better get back to work.
Okay.
Adrian, who is that woman? Who is she?
That's Harriet.
I don't want her around our house, so you had better get rid of her.
September 14th, 1889. Dear Diary, I grow increasingly fearful of Zoltan. I feel the burn of his eyes upon me as he watches my every move. Did my little girl have such fears? Did she suffer when he snuffed out her baby life? How could people believe him when he said it was an accident? It was no accident. But, dear diary, Zoltan wasn't always like this. I remember, not so long ago, when he was loving and gay. He was overjoyed when Sophia was born. I know, I remember. But after his trip to Paris last year, he changed. Something happened to him. I don't know what. Now, all I have left are my plants. I spend most of my time in my greenhouse, as far away as I can get from Zoltan's ever-watchful eyes.
You dirty, rotten, stinking, filthy son of a bitch. You stay away from my wife.
Just what are you accusing me of, sir?
I know exactly what you're doing here.
John, shut up! I think you better leave.
Eight thirty.
There you are.
What is it, Cyrus?
It's Ma. She told me to tell you to come to Dubon.
Wait. What for, Cyrus?
I think it has something to do with, the seance.
Oh, wait, Cyrus. I have these tarot cards I found in the house. I thought maybe your mother might like them.
Oh, darn right she would. These are beautiful. Ma! She's here!
Welcome, oh, seeker of the spirit world.
Hello, Harriet.
Please, have a seat. Let the seance begin! Spirits of the netherworld, heed us now. Talk to us, O shades of darkness. Give us a gleam of your essence. Give us a sign of your spiritual being.
I think they're biting.
Oh, restless souls, this poor gal seeks answers, answers to questions unknown. You just got to...
Oh, no.
Jesus.
Was greedy and foolish, and opened the door to the dark dimension. I released an obscenity, an entity of pure evil. It had been contained. But now the pestilence is free to infect once more. You are the chosen one. Only you can send it back. Find the dragon. It will show the way.
Cyrus?
You don't know?
Know what?
Harriet, you did it. You really did it.
You're not pulling my leg now, are you?
No, I wouldn't do that.
never happened before. Hot diggity! Oh, Cyrus! Cyrus! I did it! I really did it!
What the hell? What is this? The dragon will lead the way.
Oh my God, secret panel.
Too far. That'd be a long jump.
Thank you.
It's only open from the other side. John?
God, look at you. I don't care anymore. I just don't care. I'm going to bed. Don?
Adrian.
Are you all right, honey?
Yeah. I just hit the whiskey a little too hard last night. That's all.
Don, let's leave. Please. We gotta get out of here. Look what this place is doing to you.
Leave. Leave. This is our home, Adrian. We can never leave this place. Oh, what do you want?
Hi. Yeah,
I don't care about the damn phone.
I'll get out of here as soon as I can.
All right, fine. Get in here and fix it. And then you leave.
Son of a bitch. Thank you.
Has never been attempted before.
The incredible Carno will defy death in this, his newest feat, featuring the horrifying Throne of Terror.
What are you doing, Marie?
Why?
I slept with him last night. Admit it, you're still seeing him, aren't you?
No, you're out of your mind.
We have all been waiting for. Ladies and gentlemen, the incredible Carno!
Go to hell.
Thank you.
Carno and Malcolm, 1897.
Yes? What do you want?
Well?
Here, I wanted to give Malcolm this old photo. I found it at the Carnavash estate.
Mm-hmm.
It's a photo of Malcolm and Carno. See what's written on the back? See Malcolm as a young boy. Please, you've got to let me in to see Malcolm. It's important.
Just a minute. Malcolm will see you now.
She is here, Malcolm. Set.
I remember. What was it? This picture. I was just a young nipper of 10. Carno was my hero. Then.
Your hero?
Yeah. I know what you saw in this picture.
Saw?
Yeah. The evil. It's back.
And my husband?
It meant me too late for him.
What?
Young lady, sit down. I have something to tell you. Carno and his first wife adopted me. At that time, he was a good man, respected by his colleagues, loved by his wife, admired by his audiences. But all that changed when he got the book. He gained immense powers through contact with the black forces. Through the book, he unleashed a demon, an entity so evil it had no name, no worldly description. This thing came to possess Carno, body and soul. Carno became like it. He became very powerful, and his fame and his wealth increased. But he was cursed. He had loved his wife Hortensia and their baby daughter. But all that changed. He became abusive. I don't have proof, but I believe he killed them both. I believe he killed all his wives.
But Malcolm, what happened the night Carno and Marie died?
Carno's final days came when Marie took up with his prop man, Gaston Warwick. Obviously, Marie suspected Carno of committing terrible deeds with herself as his next victim. Together, Marie and Gaston hatched a plan. He had a new act, an amazing feat of escape. But Marie rigged the machine. Carno couldn't escape. They figured it would kill him. It almost did. For 2 weeks, Carno lay in a coma. But then, one night, he awoke, swearing revenge. I saw Carno drag an unconscious Gaston into his theater. There, from within the secret passages, I watched as Carno tortured and mutilated the poor man, leaving him dead. Then it was Marie's turn. Totally crazed, nothing but pure revenge on his mind, Carno started up that god-awful machine, that awful contraption. And before my very eyes, I saw Marie die. I'll never forget the look of shocked surprise on Carno's face. Poor Gaston was dying. This was his final heroic act. To my horror, I then saw a demon. That's all I know to call it. Leave his body and disappear through the theater floor. I knew where it was going. Carno knew it too. My only thought was running away, but I hesitated when I saw Carno going to the same place the demon had gone. I rushed back to the hidden passages, just in time to see Carnot carrying the chest which held that evil muck. Then, just before reaching the chapel, he stumbled and fell for the last time. I saw him cross himself in the Catholic way before dying. I think he was trying to make his peace with God. I picked up the chest containing that horrid book, and I assume the demon itself, and carried it into the chapel. I really don't know what I thought I was doing, but somehow I felt as if I were containing this cursed evil. I had hoped forever. After leaving the chapel, I then dragged Carnot's body back to his secret chamber, where he now lies.
But wait, Carnot's not in his tomb?
No, that is Gaston Warwick. He was so mutilated that they all thought he was Carnot. I said nothing. I let them think what they wanted.
And what about the demon?
The demon? Oh, that's why I agreed to talk with you. Somehow, it must have been released.
Oh my God. Dawn. What can we do?
The only answer is the accursed book. Oh, with it, you've got to send that thing back to where it came from. Back to the other side. You have seen the book.
Yes.
I thought so. All right, young woman. You're the only one who can do this. Your husband's soul is ensnared. I'm not sure what I can do or what can be done for him. But if you can somehow get close to the demon, here's what you can do. You'll need the book, a holy item, the stone of Hammurabi, and the blood of a sentient being. Now, take the book and...
Okay, Adrian, you're all set.
Great.
Phone's in and it works just fine. Why don't you go ahead and test it?
Okay. Mike, I want to apologize for Dawn again. He just hasn't been himself lately. I mean, normally Only he's a very nice guy. Really.
Yeah, don't even worry about it. It's no big deal. You call me if you have any trouble, okay?
I will. I sure will, thanks.
Go like this. Gotta do something.
look at this. This must be Carno's family tree.
Thank you.
America.
Oh my God.
A woman's body is a wonderful thing, but the head is useless. You are a very good subject, Adrian. You cooperated with me very well.
Thank you.
It's in Latin. Can I remember this? Date intra circulum magicum. Let's see. Stand inside circle. Magic circle. I'm already in the circle. Ponete fascinum in paganum apertum liberi. Place talisman in open book page. Talisman? Shit.
Tenete hoc batum super fascinum et cantate hoc carmen. Hold blessed item over talisman and say this incantation.
Mundi tenebricosi.